So right now we are designing a hospital. Now, what is the general perception of a hospital building or as a facility in, say, in India? You know, we have grown up from the childhood, we have seen many, many hospitals and healthcare buildings. So it becomes very sterile, very clinical, very cold, and you have to behave in a certain way. You feel like you are caged, you do not have certain amount of freedom. When this project came to us, we started questioning, you know, frame by frame. We said, okay, so this is the prevailing trend or mindset of a hospital building, but can it be broken? Can we do something else? So our client was extremely generous. They said, yeah, let's do it. So we tried, you know. So the exploration started from there. So we said, okay, so what is the basic ingredient to break all this monotony? So we realize it's just the simple nature, which is abundantly available to us. So what does it mean? You need to capture the sun, you need to capture the wind, you need to capture the green, that's it. And our whole effort, whole concentration diverted towards that, capturing the nature. So now if you look at the building and the whole process, so many things have changed in between, but those primordial factors have never changed. So in a big footprint, it's a singular building, it's a large block and very tall. So we have created three different skylights to get the sunlight at different point of time. And we told the client, through these technologies, we have even shown them that the direction of the skylights and the placement of them, it's done in such a way that it creates a drama within the whole building. You know, you see one space from the same point from every day, but it appears to be very different. So you can gauge when the cloud is moving, is it raining or is it shiny, is it night or what? You know, so everybody liked it, and that's why I think we could bring in a lot of new stuff into a healthcare facility across the whole country. And we're very sure that this kind of facility in healthcare segment, India has not seen so far. So that is where we try to connect the bridge, you know, saying that you will get something which you have not seen before, and what we deliver at the end, that matters. So at that point of time, we don't have to say anything. The building will speak for us. So we leave it at that point.
The detailed design consultant for the Bangalore Metro Reach A, that is R1, and Reach R2A, which is the Reach 1 is from, this is Mysore Road, all the way to Magdi Road terminal. And in Reach 2A, we did it from Yashwantpur all the way to Hesargatta. So totally in the phase one, there were 43 stations in which we designed about 11 of them. In terms of designing the metro itself, at that point of time when the project came to Bangalore, there were no architects who had done metro earlier. Luckily for us, we had Brinda in our office. She had worked on the London Underground metro terminals and also the Etihad, the airport in Abu Dhabi. So she is a transport design expert, and it was an eye-opener for all of us in the office, because as a building, when you build a building, it remains stationary, right? So it doesn't move unless there's an earthquake. A metro station moves every time a train comes in. So it's designed for dynamic loading, not static loading. So imagine a train coming into a station. This station has to take that train coming in, because it's the overground stations I'm talking about, not the underground ones. So it's very complex when it comes to designing a metro station. We have to make sure that it serves its function, number one. Number two, the entire population growth, say of a city like Bangalore, we had to go through the demographic data and predict in 2040. So we designed the metro for 30 years, say 20 or 30 years. So what will be the population in 2040? And we have to make sure that the staircases, platform widths, all this is designed for population that neighborhood will have in 2040. So I'm not talking about Bangalore population alone. I'm talking about all the individual station population, let's say Vijayanagara as a neighborhood. What will it be in 2040? Because that station in Vijayanagara has to accommodate that many people, rush hour traffic at that year. So lot of data, it's number crunching actually, to arrive at the staircase width, how many lifts you need, how many escalators have to be there, what is your platform width, and how many coaches in that time will be needed, so the length of the platform. So very number crunching exercise, and you arrive then at a manifestation of a building, which is the metro station. We always wanted to do architecture that is meaningful, adds value to the city in which the building or that project is coming up, and obviously add value to the client and his company.